What? Okay, now. All right.
Here. Damn. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Kais. From this time forward, refer to me as Colonel Kais.
You enlisted in the Royal Army? You're a Selkie.
A symbolic gesture of tribal unity. Apparently, the Lilties were thrilled to have me enlist. On top of that, thanks to your crystal idol, I'm a colonel.
You know, by golly, he's gonna punch you. Seriously.
He and I live in different worlds. What good is there in hating all things Lilt? So, about the letter?
Second crystal idol? I have a good idea of where it is, but getting near it won't be easy.
I see. I have no new information. This thing is no different from any other shard, besides the color. What we need, then, is Vigali's assistance on this matter. How did it go with him, anyway? Did he try to push some job on you?
I told him that I would introduce him to a crystal reactor alternative.
Yeah, but that Lilty hater would never use an engine designed by Sid. Anyway, I'll go and deal with Vigali. You go and talk to Sid.
Are you sure about this?
Oh, come on! You're talking to a royal officer here! Hey, Lael. The Lilties say their prosperity was promised to them by their tribal crystal. What do you think? Do you believe it?
The Clavat will always be poor, crystal or no crystal. Makes no difference.
Okay. But then what are those crystals?
They say they preside over the destiny of each tribe and form the principle of the world. But it's just a myth.
Well then, what do you think crystal bearers are?
Agents of the light, or children of the dark? In reality, we're neither, nothing special.
It's unlike you to talk about yourself that way, Lael.
You made me say it, Colonel. Pondering your own existence is a waste of time. Well done. This is cool.
Come here.
This is cool.
Thank you.
Wah! 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 Yeah.
Sid, good news. We're doing a test run on Vigali's tracks.
Vigali? Silky Gil Vigali? He's a notorious Lilty hater. I'm surprised that you got him to agree to it.
Actually, he hasn't agreed to it yet. Kais said that he would convince him somehow.
Kais? That Silky who was always kowtowing to the kingdom?
He's an officer in the Royal Army now.
A Silky enlisting in the Royal Army? Talk about being confused.
Anyway, just get the steam engine to the capital grassland station. Vigali knows that he has no choice.
Oh, hold on a second, Lael. I was told to give you this message. I almost forgot about it.
Meet me at the Royal Clock Plaza at 12. Altea.
Sid, are you sure this message is for me?
She said you two were acquainted?
Well, I guess I'll have to go and see.
More time.
Oh, so it's you.
Huh?
Well, I never caught your name. You said you wanted to ask me a favor?
Yes. It's about my father. He is very ill, and it is no ordinary illness. Where medicine fails, magic may succeed. Perhaps there are those with healing powers. Do you know of any bearers like that?
Althea. All bearers have some degree of power. But because of that, they're distrusted by the public. Do you really think that such outcasts would use their powers righteously for the benefit of humanity? To this day, I've never seen a bearer with healing powers.
They may not be righteous, but do you think bearers with healing powers may exist?
It's better if they didn't exist. You would have to be willing to sacrifice an entire city to get the cooperation of a crystal bearer like that.
A kingdom. That's what I am ready to sacrifice.
That's some big talk, little miss. I'm hungry. Let's grab a bite. What do you want?
I am being completely serious, Lael.
Yeah, I'll be right back to hear more. An entire kingdom? Interesting.
His Majesty the King has fallen ill, but you sit here drinking afternoon tea.
I am trying to find a cure.
Please tell me what his symptoms are. I can be of assistance.
This is a royal family matter. You need not get involved.
Well then, I implore you to fulfill your duties as his proxy, Princess. We must go before the Elder Council, where you will give me full authority to deal with the Uke threat.
That goes against my father's policies. He wants military authority to be decreased.
Why then does His Majesty not say so himself in front of the Elder Council?
Very well. Let us go to the Council.
After all that talk, aren't you giving up a little too easily?
Yay!
Bye.
Stop being so stubborn. Just say that you bought it from me.
That's no good. I would know the truth.
Call me an onion, will you? Keep that up and I'll be taking this back home.
No! Get out of here!
Oh, really? Come on, guys. Act your age.
Guys, you little punk! What's with the outfit?
That's Colonel Kice of the Royal Army to you. Sid's steam engine will be purchased by the Army for military development.
Hold on there! We claimed it first! Isn't that right, Val?
Yeah. Sorry, Kice, but Vigali was here first.
Hurry up and get this steam engine on my locomotive!
I've never seen anything like this, so I don't know where to start.
Hey, Lilty! How about some product assistance?
It's Sid! I'll oversee everything until it's running. Don't worry about it.
You smell more like grease than onions.
By golly, is there any new information? Do you know where the Uke's headed?
The Guild always has new info, kid. The Uke's in the ravine, headed for the snowfields. Get in the train. It'll take you close by. If I ever see your face again, you'll be in a world of pain!
Well done, Colonel Kais.
Manipulating Vigali is not the hardest task in the world. Although, like he says, the next meeting might hurt.
Quack, quack, quack.